हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हर्ष राठौर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, सेज यूनिवर्सिटी भोपाल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू ऑन सब्जेक्ट एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज एंड डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट। टॉपिक इज कंपोनेंट ऑफ एनवायरमेंट। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई थ्रो लाइट ऑन एटमॉस्फियर, and today I will explain you in brief about the remaining component of environment like lithosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere. So let us start with lithosphere. What is lithosphere? The lithosphere is the solid rock that covers the planet. This includes the crust as well as the very uppermost part of mantle, which is also called solid rock. Even all of the rock on earth from the mountain to the sea floor is included in the lithosphere. This is the section of earth which consists of inner core, outer core, mantle and lithosphere. Ultimately, inner core is made up of solid iron and nickel, and which is about 1200 kilometers. Then outer core, which is made up of liquid iron and nickel, and which is about 2,250 kilometers. Then mantle is made up of dense rock, and it is about 2,900 kilometers. Then lithosphere, which is about 100 kilometers. Here is also crust pile, which is about 40 kilometers and made up of solid lighter rock. This is the another view of Earth section, which show inner core, outer core, mantle, lithosphere, as well as the division of land and water on the earth surface. Now, what is lithosphere and the solid earth? The solid earth lies beneath the atmosphere and the ocean, and it composed 29% of earth surface. It is further divided into several distinct units or layers. This is called what I call lithosphere solid earth. There are two types of crust. One is oceanic crust and another is continental crust. Oceanic crust is thinner, denser and usually darker in color, and continental crust is lighter in weight, less dense, light in color. Here you can see oceanic crust and continental crust of Earth's lithosphere. Now, what are the basic difference between continental crust and oceanic crust? Continental crust is very thick, which is about 10 to 70 kilometer. Oceanic crust is thin, nearly 7 kilometer. Second point, continental crust is buoyant, less dense than oceanic crust. Oceanic crust is dense. Third is ocean continental crust mostly old, and the oceanic crust is young. This is the geographical division of Earth, which show different continental countries and ocean. Now, what is hydrosphere? All the water on or near the earth surface is hydrosphere. It includes ocean, lake, river, wetland, ice cave, cloud, soil, rock layer beneath the surface. 71% of earth surface covered by water. Approximately 70% of Earth's surface is water, and remaining 30% of Earth's surface is only land. These are the percentage distributions. Here, I will show you only 1% of total water is available as a fresh water. 2% is in the ice form, And the remaining 97% is salt water, which is very huge. Here are the few points on hydrosphere. Water is the universal solvent and the basis of all life on our planet. Water on Earth is unique feature that clearly distinguishes our blue planet from the other in solar systems. And the third point is very unique and very beautiful. Not a drop of liquid water can find anywhere else in the solar systems. Earth has just the right mass, right chemical composition, the right atmosphere, and the right distance from the sun that permit water to exist mainly as a liquid. Now, last, biosphere. Biosphere is the region in which life can exist. All the human beings can live their life in the biosphere. So, biosphere is basically a sphere which is made up of three parts like atmosphere, hydrosphere, exosphere, and this is all about biosphere. These are the tutorials questions from my previous video. Put the layer of atmosphere in order. Second, in which layer do we live? Third, in which layer is the ozone layer formed? Fourth, which layer is the middle? Fifth, what happens to the air pressure the higher you go up? So, thanks, students. I hope you like this video. Stay tuned with us.